Hi guys, this is the third lecture of the digestive system. In the previous lecture, we discussed about the structure of teeth. There I forgot to say one thing, the enamel and the dentine is made up of calcium and phosphate. Okay, so we have to make a note of that. Okay, and then there is some term called as mottling. Okay, just check with that what is the meaning of mottling, because in one of the paper it was asked. Okay, I'll just give you as an assignment, just see what is a mottling, because in a mottling you see the role of fluoride and the calcium ion. Okay, so okay, continuing our discussion today, we are going to discuss the next structure of the buccal cavity, tongue. What is tongue? Tongue is a made up of smooth or skeletal. So the answer is it is made up of skeletal, because skeletal is something which is voluntary in action. Smooth is something which is involuntary in action. So tongue, which is under our control, is made up of skeletal muscle. Now, if you see the structure of tongue, okay, we see the three part. Okay, I have divided into anterior 2/3 and posterior 1/3. Okay, so this 2/3 part, we have certain important structure. Here we have the circumvillate papillae. There we have three types of papillae or the taste bud in the tongue. So we have circumvillate papillae, then we have fungiform papillae, then we have filiform papillae. Now fungiform, you know, fungi ke structure mein hoga, filiform conical shape mein hoga, circumvillate round shape mein hoga. Circumvillate is a least in number, whereas filiform is most in number, and fungiform moderate. Okay, now this papillae, these are surrounded by, supplied by blood vessels, and surrounding the blood vessels we have nerves. These nerves have the sensation which gives us the taste of the food or anything. So we have sweet, sour, salt, bitter taste according to that. Okay, now behind the posterior 1/3 of the tongue, it is whitish in color because there is a lack of papillae over there. In front of this anterior 2/3, we have red papillae. Why it is red? Just now I said it is supplied by the blood. Okay. Now, now one more thing. See, this tongue is very important because there are certain medicine which is sublingual. So the moment you keep on the tongue, it directly goes to the brain because of that papillae only, which takes the sensation and gives to the, that nerves carry the information to the brain. Okay. Now, there is one important structure which you should know, that the tongue, the beneath part of the tongue is attached with the some cartilaginous fold, which is called as, or cartilage, it's made up of cartilage, or you can say sometime, because attachment is a ligament. So some books they write ligament, some book they write cartilage, so that doesn't matter. We should know the structure of that, which is the name of the structure, which is frenulum. So frenulum is the structure which connects the tongue to the floor of the buccal cavity. Okay, and now the tongue is only the skeletal muscle which is not attached to any bones. Okay, so with this we should know what is the function of the tongue. So function of the tongue, we know already, we have seen there is a gustatory receptor which gives the sensation of the food. Then we have the tongue for the proper mixing of the food, and then there is an important term related to the digestion of food which is called as deglutition. So what is the function of deglutition? So deglutition is nothing but swallowing down of the food, okay, by the upper movement of the tongue. So the moment the tongue moves up, the food which is mixed with the saliva goes down. Okay, so this is called as, this process called as deglutition. So here we got to know the function of the tongue. One is it has gustatory receptor. Second, it is helping in mixing of the food, and the proper deglutition. Thank you so much. We'll meet in the next class.